Hello there, Ticket Stubs viewers. First and foremost, we just want to wish everyone the best with what's going on right now. Definitely a difficult time for many, and staying safe is definitely the most important thing. And we all wish you well, and definitely stay safe for sure.
Yeah. Weird times. Interesting stuff going on with this virus, and we hope that everyone's taking it seriously and, doing the right thing and staying safe for your loved ones and all that good stuff. But that being said, Joey and I thought, since we're all quarantined here together, right, or well, hopefully separate, we'd go through our list of, best streaming movies you can watch like right now. So what Joe and I did is just kind of scrolled through the menus, and we're doing the hard work for you that first like hour of just clicking through and not knowing what the heck to click on. And then you get tired and end up like watching a 30-minute show and going to bed. We're breaking through that, and we're going to give you our not top five, but just five random movies that we saw on a couple different streaming platforms that are ready to click on and start watching.
Very, very well said, Alex. What is the first movie on your list? Definitely, like you said, no better time to stay in and check out some movies.
Yeah, so I guess I'll go with Netflix first. I kind of broke them up into like a couple different services here. So my top one on Netflix that I just picked out, and these are maybe not like my best movies. Some of them are really good, but it's more of like maybe stuff you haven't seen before or like something that's worth a rewatch if you have seen it. So I'm going to go ahead with Icarus. It's a documentary film on Netflix. I believe it's a Netflix original. It's about the doping scandal with Russia and the Tour de France and some of the Olympics. And this documentary is insane. If you've never watched it, it plays like a James Bond spy movie, and like them filming the documentary like leads to stuff happening to the crew during it. And it's like it'll blow your mind how much of a spy thriller it seems like, but it's real life and it's actually happening to these people like while they're filming it. And like it is crazy, unbelievable. Like your heart's pounding. Like there's a couple documentaries every couple of years, like maybe the Don't Mess with Cats one was close to this, but in a way darker, weirder way, that just make your heart pound and you just can't stop watching it. So Icarus on Netflix, that's a good one.
Yeah, I still need to check that one out. I remember after you saw it, you texted me saying like, I just saw the most mind-blowing documentary. And right now is definitely a great time to learn new things. And documentaries are always awesome ways to do that. And
dang it, Joey, I'm making this list for you because apparently you haven't seen some of these.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I need to. And like you said, the spy thriller element sounds super interesting. So continuing the Netflix theme, this one definitely one of my go-to Netflix recommendations for sure. Ex Machina. This was one that you definitely brought up to me before I saw it too, so I'm so glad you told me about it. And this is one, such an intriguing story. It's almost like a puzzle. You're just trying to figure out what's going on, and the characters. There's only a few characters in this film, so that makes it, really get the focus on those characters. And I think also too, like the setting kind of, I think in the same way how like, kind of like the setting is that one location setting. I think that kind of goes well with staying at home in the sense that it really puts you there, kind of that mindset of being kind of in that one location. I think that watching in that aspect would make it even a more intriguing film for sure.
That could have been a list all in itself. It was just movies that take place in one set. You could throw a bunch of those together. what's the Tarantino one? Like the one of his first films.
Reservoir
Dogs. Yeah. That's a good one. You could put Parasite on there. Like stuff that all happens kind of in one area. That Rear Window, that would be a good one. Like, yeah, that could have been maybe we'll do a separate video on that. That could be a whole list on itself. But no, that's Ex Machina is a great film and definitely worth checking out if you haven't seen kind of the deeper cuts on some of these, but they're excellent. So next one on my list, I guess I'll keep it with Netflix. We'll do Netflix right off the bat because it seems like that's the more popular one that people are more likely to have. This is a great one. If you had an excuse early on not to watch it, you have zero excuses now. The Irishman. You got all the time in the world, folks. You better be watching that Irishman. It's like 4 hours long, but it is well worth it. And shoot, I mean, what are you going to do the rest of the week? Maybe break it up into hour chunks and watch it every day. Like, it is an awesome movie from 2019. And it is just the best kind of like put it on and have yourself a scotch and watch a mob epic from Martin Scorsese. So The Irishman is definitely one of my top Netflix ones. And that's going to be like right when you click on the main menu. So check out The Irishman.
Oh yeah. All perfectly said. Yeah. That one, like you said, there's no better time to sit down and really, really invest yourself in that movie. Cause if you do fully invest in it, so worth it. Such a great cast. And it is really like one, like you really get kind of into put into that world. And yeah, that's a really awesome one to check out for sure. Which streaming service should we go with next, Alex?
How about we go Amazon Prime?
Amazon Prime? All right, Amazon Prime. There's one movie on my list that's on Prime and Hulu, but we'll go with the one that's just on Prime. This is one you and I saw together in August of 2017. And I think this is just an awesome, the super entertaining comedy film with a great cast, and it is a great heist film. Logan Lucky. This is one that is just it is a great comedy that'll just put a lighthearted comedy that is just such a fun movie to figure out too, as with any heist movie. So I think. It has that heist movie element. It's funny. The characters are so awesome, and definitely one that you can really not only laugh but also really like get invested in the with what's going on too. So it's a really fun one to watch.
I knew this would be the one that we had both on our list. Logan Lucky, Amazon Prime, 100% has to be on there. This is like a classic, like totally take yourself out of the real depressing world and watch like a really fun. Almost backwoods like Ocean's 11 kind of movie, and it is so much fun. Daniel Craig playing a Southern accent is like hot in the streets now because we just came right off of Knives Out. So catch him before you go see James Bond, which is delayed now. So we at least get some more distance between this and that, so we can see him as a cool guy again instead of a goofy Southerner. Logan Lucky, totally awesome. Great, suspend your disbelief and just hang out and watch a fun film. So my other Prime one, and I think this is an Amazon Prime original from 2019, Late Night. So this is one of the ones that I threw in there in the mix just to try to get to that like 40 movie threshold last year when we were doing our reviews. And I actually really enjoyed it. Like it's like an average of the road kind of Rotten Tomatoes score, I believe, for a comedy. But Mindy Kaling, is that, I forget her last name all the time. What's the leading woman's name? I can picture it, but I can't think of it. Should have been more prepared for this. Late Night's awesome. It's kind of like a dying SNL type daily show type show that's having some trouble like reaching out to younger audiences, and Mindy gets to come in, and her character gets to shake things up. She doesn't come from a comedy background. She comes from like a STEM type background, and it's really kind of a heartwarming movie. But it's just a good time, and it's a decent comedy that you probably flew under your radar, so it's worth streaming for sure.
Yeah, I like the concept of I definitely I'm glad you brought that one up, because I need to see that one too. And I like what you said about being like a film about a late night comedy show. I mean, 30 Rock is such a fun show, and I love how it's about that element, and this kind of seems similar to that. And Mindy Kaling, she's fantastic, and right now is a great time for just a throwing out a comedy film and laughing, and that sounds like it definitely fulfills that.
So you said you had one that's Prime Hulu, so that'll go right into my next Hulu one. So Joey, what's your Prime Hulu?
First and foremost, I just have to thank our good friend John for introducing me to this movie. It's a fun one to watch. It takes place in one location, and it is Coherence. And this one is, without giving too much away, it's just about a group of friends at a party. And, you know, something interesting kind of happens, and that's all I'll say about that. But it is super fun to watch, and it is one that you can kind of go back and rewatch, and different things mean different things at certain points, and you should. That's definitely fun right now. And I kind of with Ex Machina, I think the fact that you're kind of stuck in one location, and in this movie kind of is kind of not necessarily stuck in one location, but it is one location too. It kind of, I think it will definitely adds to the atmosphere a little bit. And Coherence, it is so much fun. And yeah, it is definitely going to go into knowing as little as possible for sure.
Interesting. Yeah. There's not too much to go on there, but you definitely, your excitement about it makes me just want to click on it right now. So I really, that's one I haven't seen. So I'm going to have to check that one out. You know, this list is more just for Joey and I to get through and make our way through the next couple of weeks. So my Hulu pick, and I just did one because I don't know, do people still use Hulu? It's around. It actually, you know what, it kind of flies under the radar of having like some pretty decent movies every once in a while. I just never check it. Mine is I, Tonya. So the last time that a story took the world by storm, maybe not the last time, a few times ago at least, but was way more, I guess, lighthearted, or at least not this grim as coronavirus, was Tonya Harding in her Olympic chase for gold and everything that went down. This is just a really, really fun, upbeat, quick comedy, but drama. Won a ton of awards, had great performances. Margot Robbie's amazing in it. This is, if you want a movie that just takes you away from everything and brings you back into when the real world was the real world, albeit in, I believe, the 80s, that's a great flick to throw on for sure.
Super well said, Alex. That film was the next one on my list as well, so I'm so glad you awesome choice. And I think you really encapsulated it well. It kind of brings you back into that world again. That and it works so well. It's not only being this kind of historical biopic-esque film, but it also is just told in such an incredibly entertaining fashion. So if you want, it kind of fulfills both of those notions. Definitely a great one to watch. Margot Robbie's fantastic, and Alex was a very dedicated fan of this movie. He drove pretty far to see this one, so I will always, I am so glad he did that, because I remember he texted me saying like, Joey, you need to see this movie right now. and that got me so hyped to go see it.
That rush hour was well worth it. Awesome film. Mm-hmm. So Joe, finish off our list here. What's our last easy to go to streaming movie right now?
Well, this is definitely going to be the most cliche answer on here for sure. And it's actually worked out perfectly, because this is on this is one that's on Disney Plus, and
I didn't have Disney Plus. That's a great point. That is a streaming service that is out now.
This is not going to be one that when you hear this, you'll be like, yeah, I know why this is on here. But Disney Plus, I mean, there really is no better time to start the Marvel Cinematic Universe if you haven't yet. Iron Man, watch it. It's on Disney Plus. If you haven't seen it, and it's just on its own, if you don't want to watch the other films, that's totally fine, because Iron Man by itself is definitely awesome. But if you want to, you could watch a film a day for the next, and I don't think all of them are on Disney Plus yet, but a good majority of them are, and I think they're continuously adding more. I know they just added Black Panther. So you definitely start Iron Man, and you got a film for, you know, at least the next 20 days or so, if depending. I don't think they have them all yet. Definitely somewhere in that range. But yeah, Iron Man.
Perfectly said. That's I love that you went there, not Avengers. Like, this is a really great time to start the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Like with any good show, right? No excuses. Like, it's time to step up and do it. So I guess with that, Joey, do you have like one show recommendation for people to check out that they could just binge right through right now?
Yes, and I'm glad you brought up. You said, I know you said Hulu kind of has some like kind of people. I forgot what word you used. Not like under the radar. So Hulu, Community is on Hulu right now, and then Community is also going to be on Netflix on April 1st. So two streaming services, you can check the show out, and I'm sure I knew about it a little bit, and our good friend Nick, he recommended it to me, and I checked it out, and it's 6 seasons, and, you know, 25-minute episodes, so just... And it just, they go by so fast. They're each their own. It is, each one is like its own movie in a way, but it's so, not necessarily own movie in a way, but they do really a lot of cool genre stuff and great cast. And yeah, that's kind of a good TV recommendation for sure. So many, like, heard so many good things. So I'm so glad I finally got to see it. And how about you, Alex?
No, that's perfect. I think a 20-minute comedy is like right what you need right now. Just something that you pop on and have a mood booster, you know? Yeah. I'll hit you with a different, an hour long comedy, kind of comedy. It's comedy drama. Marvelous Miss Maisel. If you have not seen this show yet, it is, I know Joey is, it's been hard to get him into it, but for everybody else, this movie is incredible, or this show is incredible.
Well, each episode is kind of like a movie based on, well told. Like,
it really is. It's so well told, so well written. The production value is insane. Like, if you just watch it for like the, like, season 3 has a ton of musical elements in it, and it's just like, it's so well done. You know, having this hour-long comedy just to grind through right now is a perfect time. I feel like I had something else to say about it, but it is the best well put together show that I've watched since Breaking Bad. And I know, like, everybody says, like, that's the best show since Breaking Bad, whatever. It's awesome. I love it. I'm so invested in it, and I just can't get enough of it.
I like you said, production value is incredible, and the cast is incredible, and I think I'm 3 episodes in, so I definitely you might have just I think you just did an awesome job of convincing me to start watching it again. Cause yeah, I mean, the season 3 just released, I know you mentioned that. And so definitely a good one to start. And yeah, I'm sorry. I haven't gotten back into it yet. I definitely need to.
That's all right. Hey, real quick. I just scribbled down a couple apocalyptic movies that are on my list. If you want to check those out too, I don't know what the streaming status of these are. I think we actually checked a couple of them. This is probably a rent list. But I thought it was fun to put together. So top 5 apocalyptic movies on my list. This Is the End. Awesome. Fun. Celebrities hanging out. James Franco, Seth Rogen, do the apocalypse together. World's End. Great Simon Pegg movie. Part of his trilogy. The whole premise is that they're going to do a bar crawl called The World's End to get to all these bars in their town. And then the apocalypse happens during it, and they get to continue to do it. And it's awesome. Hilarious. I Am Legend. That's a great one. Will Smith. I don't know. I probably haven't seen it in like 8 years, but it was awesome back then. Maybe it's still awesome now, but it's cool to see somebody just hanging out in like a city of no one, because that's kind of like what it's like right now. Independence Day, I don't know if that counts, but pretty apocalyptic at parts, and it's a pretty rah-rah America, so that's a good one to throw on. Definitely not 2, don't watch 2, 2's terrible. 10 Cloverfield Lane is probably the newest one. That one was pretty not gruesome, but like creepy and like not horror-ish, but definitely you know, thriller and everyone does a great job in that movie, and it is the best Cloverfield by far. So, yeah, that's 5 apocalyptic movies for you. I don't know. Joey, can you think of one?
Well, I'm so glad you brought up 10 Cloverfield Lane.
I sprung this on you right away.
No, yeah, that was awesome.
Where'd that one go? I haven't seen that since theaters, but it was great when it was in theaters.
Yeah, that was an awesome movie, and kind of goes along with like the one location kind of stuck feeling.
We just did a whole list of action movies just right off, like, on the cuff here.
And I want to apologize on camera. Alex invited me to see This Is the End in June of 2013, and I said no. That's out there.
You feel good? You feel like you got that off your chest finally?
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm Independence Day, awesome. So Apocalypse. Your list was, man. Oh god.
Named all the good ones already. I took them all.
All so well said.
I haven't seen Day After Tomorrow. I've seen like parts on TV, like everyone else has, but
Day After Tomorrow. That, I mean, it is definitely cheesy early 2000s, but in the best kind of way, for sure. That's it. That'd be
2012 sucked, other than Woody Harrelson, right?
Oh, I don't know what I haven't seen 2012. I don't know Woody Harrelson.
Yeah, it's not good. Don't watch it. It ain't worth it.
Hey, you gave it a chance. That's all. It's you did. You tried.
Yeah.
Maybe. Oh, I know there's.
It was harder to come up with this list than I thought it was. So, I apologize for springing this on you.
World's End's that's an awesome one too, for sure.
I just like, yeah, I like a good comedy with the apocalypse.
Yeah, I think out of all the, 10 Cloverfield Lane, that when you said that really like that. I mean, all of them were awesome, but that one, like, oh my god, like that one, I forgot how awesome that movie was.
Because that one was kind of like an infection type movie. But yeah, no, yeah, I don't know. We just spit a ton of movies out for you to go stream, and hope you make the best of the time going on here. Great time to get into shows, that's for sure.
Absolutely. And also is a great time to cuddle with any pets you might have. And speaking of which,
first appearance on the pod.
Alex is Leo. Meet Leo, everybody.
I just woke him up from the nap on my lap. He was sitting there the whole time.
Oh, Leo. Hey, the
So yeah, maybe some Air Bud movies heading our way.
Oh my! Oh, those movies. What's your favorite of all the Air Bud movies?
Probably the soccer one, right? No, basketball. Duh. Are you kidding me? What's the basketball one? I don't know. That was the best one.
Soccer one it might be okay. Yeah, I don't remember that one too much.
I guess. Like it's probably that's probably all of them, right? So anyway, yeah. Thank you guys for tuning in, and hope quarantine goes well, and we'll check in every couple once in a while, and maybe give some more suggestions on how to keep busy.
Absolutely. You proved with the apocalyptic list and the one location list, there's many video idea possibilities. So we'll see what happens over the next few weeks.
Oh yeah, sure. That's right, folks. All right, stay safe. Wash your hands.
Stay safe. Yeah, perfectly said, Alex. Have a good night, everybody.